everyone, and welcome to the La Canola shooting range here in Milan, Italy. It's the second stage of the ISSF World Cup in Rifle and Pistol, and I'm here with USA's rifle shooter, Henry Gray. Welcome, Henry, or Hank, I'll call you.
Ah, yes, thanks, Hillary.
We've nice got an eighth place, coming with 596 points, representing Serbia, Nemanja Miroslavljev. And it's good to see him in. He was shooting very well during sighting.
Yeah, absolutely.
In seventh place with 597 points, representing Austria, we have Alexander Schmil. This is the first time that he's been in a World Cup.
Wow. Well, congratulations to him.
Yeah.
That's good to see new young shooters in there.
I know. Then in sixth place with 597 points, representing Switzerland, we have Simon Bierley. And this is also a new face.
Yes, yeah. I've been kind of noticing that he's been, you know, continually rising. Actually, I think it even shows there on the screen that he's, you know, getting better and better all the time. So that's good to see as well.
And you were saying this is your wife's brother.
We like to joke that this is my wife's brother because they have very similar names, by former names.
Former, right. And in fifth place with 597 points, representing Belarus, we have Vitaly Bubnovich. And in fourth, with 597 points, representing Hungary, we have Peter City. And you know Peter quite well, I'm sure.
Yes, of course. Yeah, Peter's been around for quite a while, and he's been in this position pretty frequently as well.
That's true. And in third place, with 599 points, representing the Ukraine, we have Shurhi Kulish. And also, he has never entered into a final round of a World Cup. It's pretty interesting that we've got these, you know, new faces going against some really veteran shooters.
Yeah, absolutely. That is that's very interesting. I see there he's got a silver from the World Championships,
but
nothing in the World Cup.
Then in second place with 599 points, representing Italy, we have Niccolò Campriani.
Oh, of course, Nico, here he is trying to do it for the home crowd today, and we'll see what he can do. I think he's been shooting very well, and we'll have quite the battle.
I think so. I think you're right, because he's also tied up for first place. And here he is in first place, representing the People's Republic of China, Chu Qinan.
And he's another one, needs no introduction. everybody knows who Kina.
That is true. You know, we had a seven-way shoot-off for eighth place today. Just goes to show how tight the results really were today, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. Air rifle here has just been amazing. The scores just continue to rise, and the shoot-offs get tougher and tougher. And
which just means that the athletes are getting better and better and stronger and stronger. Yeah, and, you know, with the Olympic Games right around the corner, I think everyone's kind of got their eyes on that at this point, but I think these gentlemen are here today for the gold. They want the World Cup.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, you were saying that the USA is going to have their trial selection at the end of June?
It's at the first part of June.
First part of June.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's, we already, of course, took care of the air rifle selection portion of it, but this will be just the small bore selection, mm-hmm. and we've got one spot in each event available. Because we have some guys that qualified early, so.
So it's a little bit unnerving, I'd have to say, for all of you that, you know, are looking for that one spot.
Absolutely. It's tough, you know, to be on a team, but be fighting for one spot.
That's true. That is true. But here you can see it. We've got our eight finalists here, and there's really only, 3 points from first to eighth place. So it's going to prove to be quite tight, I believe. You know, we've got Chu and Campriani. They are, and of course City as well, who probably have, and also Miroslavljev, who have more experience, let's say, than a couple of the other guys that are here. But, you know, these guys have never entered into a World Cup before and have entered into this final. Anything can probably happen, I would think.
Yeah, absolutely. Sometimes, you know, that kind of fresh new blood, fresh new meat, it's a good way you can kind of come in and just, you know, be head on, full head of steam, and
take these
other guys by surprise.
And the pressure is really going to be on Campriani. And I think that he's actually putting up to pressure a whole lot better than he was a couple years ago. He seems like he's a little bit more calm going into finals. I'm not speaking for him by any means, because I have no idea what goes on in his mind or how he's feeling, but he's not showing the nervousness that he used to. I think it was about 2 years ago, you know? And I know that he's had some great training in the U.S., and you've trained with him as well, is
that
right?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, he spent quite some time over there training in Colorado Springs and shot a bunch of matches with him. Mm-hmm. And I would have to agree with you, Hillary, that he really has come a long ways. And of course, he's, you know, been great, but I think he's really started to really move to that next step.
I think so, too. And, you know, Chu, what can you say? He's been winning and winning and winning. It's been amazing. He actually made it into the final in London, just recently in London. And I believe he actually ended up in eighth place, which was surprising.
Right.
No one was expecting that. So we'll have to see how this goes for him today. I'm sure that he's hungry for the gold medal. And I don't even know if China's already had their selection.
Right, yeah, actually, I'm not familiar with that
no,
as well.
No, every country has their own time frame, I think. And I think if you're going from a smaller country, generally you know. You know,
yeah.
If you're coming from San Marino, you have an idea if you're going to be in or not. But some of the other countries, the large ones like Italy, like America and China, I think that it must be a really interesting way to how the selection matches must go. It must be.
Yeah, I know. Actually, our process has changed, you know, over the last few Olympics. It used to be just wide open, straight up selection. You know, pretty much anybody could come try out if they wanted.
Mm-hmm.
And if you made it, you made it. You're on the team. Congratulations.
No kidding.
And so, but we've kind of changed things a little bit now, and we've got actual special points system. That comes in to play, so we can get in that a little bit later here.
Okay.
These guys are taking the first few shots.
Miroslaviev with a 10.7, nice way to start off, and let's take a look now at Schmil. I always thought it was Matthew Emmons who took the longest to shoot, but you know, Schmil's kind of
got to process their rivals him, I guess. Got us on the edge of our seat here.
It certainly does. It's 10.4. So we can take a look at the standings after the first shot. We have Chu, who started off with a 9.8, Campriani a 9.9, Kulish a 10.2, City a 10.6, Bubnovich a 10.3, 10.3 also for Baylor, Schmil a 10.4, and Miroslaviev with a 10.7. So what do we have here? We've got Campriani in first with 0.1 point advantage over Chu, and things are tight.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, and of course, CD there is with a good solid 10 to start, kind of helped take up some of that 2 point difference when he started off. So that'll keep things interesting.
And then, you know, it'll be interesting also to see how this all goes down and boils down to. Over the years, it's really come down to the last shot. And right when you think you know what's going to happen, you know, all hell breaks loose that you don't know. And that was a little thing for Jamie that I just used. Whoops.
Yeah, of course.
And the rankings change, and, you know, you kind of leave the finals hall scratching your head and thinking, wasn't expecting that.
Yep, that's for sure. You know, it's always interesting. It's hard to not look at that last shot and think that, oh, that was my chance. But sometimes it might have been the first shot. You never.
That's right.
You never know.
All right, let's take a look now at Baylor and Bubnovich. It's interesting to watch all the shooters' different ways they hold themselves, you know, their posture and everything. How, you know, let's just say Peter City, he seems like he's more ramrod straight than some of the others.
Yeah.
Chu is very straight up. And then there's some other ones that have their back in a real arch.
Scrunch right down,
yeah.
You know, that's for sure. Yeah.
It looks painful, you know.
You know, and sometimes it is very painful, and it can kind of hurt your longevity, kind of depending on, you know, just how much of a slinky spine you have.
That's right, slinky spine. 10.2 for Chu.
Okay, so him and Nico are back on track
they
now.
They certainly are, and Campriani does not want to give this away. We can take a look at the standings and see what's going on here.
Yeah, I think Nico, he extended his lead by a little bit there.
And this is after Chu had shot a 10.2, Campriani a 10.6, Kulish with a 10.4, City a 9.3, Bubnovich a 10.6, Baylor a 10.2, Schmill a 10.0, and Miroslaviev a 9.5. So Campriani now is ahead by half a point over Chu, and Chu is holding on to second place by 1.1 of a point. But we have Kulish that is sneaking up a little bit. The rest of the guys, basically, the heat is on for the bronze at this point, but we're only on, you know, two shots, so.
Yeah, I think it'll definitely be a battle there for sure, so we'll see. I'm sure the crowd is already going crazy for Nico.
I'm sure they are, too. And they certainly will. Italians certainly have a way of celebrating and to show their excitement. There's no doubt about that.
I think so.
Moving on now to shot three. And let's just focus in now on City and Kulish. Kulish, he seems very relaxed.
He looks,
Doesn't he? I mean, he looks like
really calm and just.
.5 for Kulish.
Yeah.
Nice. And a 10.7 for City.
Not to be outdone.
No, not at all. Baylor with a 10.4. And just waiting now for Schmill.
He probably just got his finger on the trigger now.
I know, really, I mean, he's really, 75 seconds sounds like, you know, nothing, but it can seem like a lifetime, you know?
Absolutely.
The 10.2 for Schmill. Campriani is kind of keeping that gap a little bit wider than it was before. This is after Chu shot a 9.5, Campriani a 10.7, Kulish a 10.5, City a 10.7, Bubnovich a 10.2, Beiler a 10.4, Schmill a 10.2, and Miroslaviev a 10.5. Campriani now with 1.7 of an advantage over Chu, and we've got everybody's chewing on Chu's heels, basically.
Yes.
He's only holding on to second place now by 0.4 of a point, tied up with Kulish and Bubnovich.
Yeah, it's definitely tightening up in there.
Yeah.
We're staying tight, I guess. They were
tight.
All tied before.
That's
so.
True. Now, it seems like Campriani, he really has gotten, like I was saying, he's really gotten into his own groove now. And I guess I'm trying to think of if it was 2 years ago, maybe, that it was the last shot that would kind of lose where he was, his standings, and it would sometimes not be in the medal standings after that last shot. So he must have worked on that a lot in these past years, because he's not letting it go anymore.
Yeah, no, that's for sure. That's, you know, gets, of course, even more difficult when you know where you're at and with the way the finals are now. It's
that's,
you know,
right.
I mean, you always had a feeling that, yeah, okay, I know I'm doing well. But now you know for sure you're doing well.
That's right. If you know, if the listeners aren't aware of the new procedures now, between every shot, the announcer announces what the shot was, what they got for points, and then after what the standings are. So if you're speaking English and you understand English, you know exactly where you are standing, and that puts a lot of pressure on.
Absolutely.
Chu with a 10.4. These two are definitely fighting it out. Yeah, with Chu with a 10.4, we had Campriani with a 10.2. Kulish with a 10.3, City with a 9.8, Bubnovich a 10.4, Baylor a 9.6, Schmill with a 10.8, and Miroslaviev with a 10.7. Campriani just lost a couple of tenths of a point with that 10.2.
Yeah, not too much damage there.
No, not too much at all. Still early on in the final, things can change around, but we'll have to keep an eye on these two. And then, of course, keep an eye on all these guys, because really there's just tenths of a point separating everybody at this point. And they're putting, you know, the pressure on Chu.
Yeah, absolutely. They're fighting hard in there. Yeah, it's interesting with the finals now, and that, you know, the announcement of the scores, you know, sometimes it's almost a little bit better, because now there's no actually wondering, well, where am I at exactly? How am I doing? Now you know where you're doing, so
yeah, that's
you
true.
Can take that as a good thing.
That's right. You know, it's good to have a positive, little positive feedback on it, because I'll tell you, when we first started off, it really threw a lot of people, and but then it seems like slowly, even now, it seems like it's almost natural for everybody to hear and to have that 10-second gap between shooting. So I guess you could say, yeah, it does. But if you're down to your last shot and they say, and with a 1/10 of a point difference between Gray, who's holding, you know, in first place, whoever, that might make you
that
a little nervous.
Yeah, it definitely tends the heart and do another speed there. Of course, at least I don't have to do the math in my head anymore like I used to. So it's helping me out.
10.4 for Bubnovich. Kulish also a 10.4. He's got an interesting style about him. He kind of has his, you know, head tilted. He looks very, very relaxed.
He does. He just looks pretty calm, cool, and collected for sure.
Campriani, who shot a 10.3.
Well, they're all about the same here on this shot.
Yeah, they are.
We'll just move on to the next one.
And a 9.8 there for Schmill. Let's take a look at the standings once again. We have Chu that shot a 10.5 and Campriani a 10.3. So it seems like almost after a couple of these shots, Campriani is losing two tenths.
2/10.
Yeah. Kulish with a 10.4, City a 10.3, Bubnovich a 10.4, Beiler 10.3, Schmill a 9.8, and Miroslaviev with a 10.5. We still have Campriani in the lead and Chu in second. Bubnovich is slowly trying to climb up there and grab on to second place, and Kulish is only 1/6 of a point behind Bubnovich.
Yeah, still, and I see Nemanja there has moved up to sixth now as well, so
yeah,
he put his name in the hat as well.
You know, Chu Kinan, he was voted this year as Shooter of the Year for 2011, actually, so that's quite a nice thing to be awarded, you know?
Yeah, that's a very big honor, especially given the level of shooting these days and the number of people that are just, you know, at the top of their game.
That's to have nice. That to add to your resume is not a bad thing, I would have to say.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, we are halfway through and on to shot six. Campriani, who speaks perfect English and understands English very well, knows exactly where he's standing now.
Absolutely.
Just waiting for the right moment.
Yeah, see if we can take a clean shot here with this. I couldn't even see his finger move.
You could not see his finger move. It was a 10.8. Look at him. He seems quite happy with that.
He's quite convinced, but he'll take it.
And why not? A 10.2 for Chu. And a 10.8 for Schmill. Nice way to go here.
To
yeah, in fact, Campriani has gained the points that he had missed before with that 10.8. Chu shot a 10.2. Kulish a 10.7. City a 10.6. Bubnovich a 10.7. Beiler an unfortunate 8.9. Schmill a 10.8. And Miroslaviev a 9.7. Campriani with almost 2 points advantage over Bubnovich, who is now tied up with Chu. And only 1/10 of a point behind those two is Kulish. I'm still not going to ask you to give me a prediction.
Oh, my goodness, yeah. You know, it always seems like at the halfway point, things get interesting, and they certainly did there.
They certainly did, it's right. And I'm sure that Chu must be feeling the pressure, you know? Like I said, he came in eighth in London, entered into today's final and was tied up for first place. And it's not like him to lose his advantage, so...
Right, yeah, you know, especially leading up into the Olympic Games, you know, you want to try and build as much momentum as you can. So I'm sure he's, you know, really wanting to do that.
I'm sure. Okay, we've got, moving on to shot seven now. Bob Nimitz, he knows where he's standing as well. And just take a look at
his car. Yeah, so far shooting a good final.
He sure is. He's placed fourth before in a World Cup, but he's never been gone home with a medal, so.
Let's see what he can do today. He's well on his way.
He certainly is. 10.5 for, 10.3 for Kulish. And Chu, a 10.5. And we'll take a look again and see what the standings have to say after Schmil takes his shot. And I have to give him the credit. I think he's overtaken Matthew Emmons for the longest person to shoot.
I think he might very well be.
okay, so we have Campriani still holding in first place after shooting a 10.6. Chu, as I said, a 10.5. Kulish, a 10.3. City, a 10.3. Bubnovich, a 10.4. Baylor, a 10.6. Schmil, a 9.9. And Miroslavyev, a 10.5. Campriani is now a solid 2 points ahead of Chu. Chu is now holding on to second place by himself by a mere 1/10 of a point over Bubnovich. Kulish is only 2/10 of a point behind Bubnovich. Got Secretary General Franz Schreiber here with us today. It's nice that he made this trip down for to see everybody. And it's been a long season, I think, for him. They've been showing up at every World Cup, and it's... a lot of traveling.
Yeah, I'm sure. I know. Well, Jamie's been traveling like crazy getting ready for the Olympic Games, and I'm sure those guys are
right.
Absolutely just as busy.
All right, so at this point, would you say that Campriani's got in the bag or not?
I would like to, but I don't want to, you know.
Don't want to jinx him.
Okay. By any means, so I'll knock on wood.
Okay, we've got enough of this surrounding us. All right, back on now to Kulish. The 10.6.
Okay.
Bubnovich also a 10.6.
That'll certainly keep him in the race there for
a
medal.
Sure will. On now to Chu. A 10.4.
It's really going to come down to the wire for those other medals, I think.
I think so, too. And a 10.6 here for Schmil. Let's take a look. We have Chu, who shot a 10.4, Campriani a 10.3. Campriani is now ahead by 1.8 tenths of a point. Kulish with a 10.6, City a 9.8. We have Bubnovich with a 10.6, Baylor, a 10.0, Schmil a 10.6, and Miroslavyev a 10.2. All right, so there's only 1/10 of a point now. Chu has moved down into third place. These are just kind of switching off by 1/10. We still have two more shots, and it's really tight.
Yeah.
Schmil, who's holding on to fifth right now, what do you think?
I think he's a little bit on the outside looking in, but he's still got a slight chance, I would say for sure. I mean, well, you're never out of it, and he's a point out of a medal right now.
Right.
With two shots to go, that's things always seem to get really interesting. I know my heart rate always goes up the last two shots. So it's kind of...
And how do you hold yourself steady? I mean, if your heartbeat is going fast...
It's amazing, you know. I've had a few times when it's been going really fast, but... you know, you look through the sights and it's like, wow, I'm actually still holding steady. I can feel and hear my heart beating, but somehow it's still in there, and so you know you can trust that you can still shoot a good shot then, even though
even though your heart is beating out of your
crazy.
Chest.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's neat when that's the case.
Well, when we were in London also, we had some really great close-ups of the shooters, and I think it was in prone position, and it was Michael McPhail, and he was shooting, and you could see his rifle move with the beats of his heart, and he shot between beats, obviously.
Yeah.
And it was really, for people that don't shoot, spectators that don't see this, it's very interesting to see that, how much pressure is on you guys, and what actually happens physically to you during the final.
Yeah, especially in prone. I mean, of course, that's the steadiest position, but there's a lot of you on the ground, transferring that beating of your heart to the gun. So
that's right. A 10.4 for Chu. So kind of taking a look at his rifle there, like something's not right here. Campriani at 10.5. So Campriani's still holding on by 1.8 tenths of a point over Bubnovich. We have Kulish and Chu now tied up for third, and only 2 tenths of a point behind Bubnovich. All right, we've got one more shot, Hank.
Okay.
All right, what do you say? Come on.
I'm feeling pretty good about Nico here.
Yeah,
I had
too.
To put, put a euro down.
A euro. There you go, Nico. See the respect you get.
However, for silver and bronze, it could be, it's still anybody's game.
Yeah.
So this last shot will be interesting to see.
And like we were saying before, all these guys, they can hear where they're standing. And we'll just have to see who can hold up to that pressure. And then we have to look out, because if Campriani wins, which I have a feeling that he definitely will, there's going to be some major celebrations going on.
Absolutely. Actually, it might not hurt to shoot before Nico on this shot if you can, because
exactly.
I'm sure the crowd may go crazy after the last shot, as soon as he shoots one. So at least be prepared for that.
That's right. Okay, it's the last shot. This is going to determine who's going to be on the podium. Kulish, who's tied up right now for third place.
Yeah, let's see what he can do here.
Nice way to finish off with a 10.6.
Ooh, yeah, that... could give him a good chance.
Campriani, 9.8.
Not great, buddy.
We were just talking about that last shot,
Yeah. Sometimes when you're way out front, you kind of get a chance to take a little deep breath and lose a little of the edge.
But it's still enough to give him the gold medal, too, a 10.4.
I think, we'll just see.
Wait a minute.
We might have a tie.
Bubnovich, a 10.6. And Schmil, a 10.6 as well. And Campriani has won. Yes, he has.
And we do have a tie. Is that right? Nope.
No,
I
we don't.
Misread it. Two
nope,
tens, two
we
tens.
Don't. We have a gold medalist right here. Niccolo Campriani from Italy. Excellent shooting from him. Came down to that last shot, and he did win by one full point over Bubnovich, our silver medalist. And let's see if we can take a look at him. This is really pretty exciting also for Bubnovich, winning his very first World Cup medal, the silver, getting congratulated by other team, other shooters. And now let's take a look and see if we can see Kulish, and there he is. Yeah, really great shooting from Kulish as well. Came down to the last shot to find out if he was going to be on it. And never entering into a final round of a World Cup and finishing off with the bronze is the right way to go.
You bet, yeah, a couple of those kind of newer faces in there, that's good.
So I'm just going to ask everyone to keep staying tuned in at 6:30 local time. We're going to have 10-meter air rifle women. And Hank, I want to wish you the best of luck during the selection match that you have, and I'm rooting for you.
Yeah, thanks so much, Hillary. I appreciate it. Hopefully we'll see you in London.
Yes, I hope so.
Ladies and gentlemen, the medal ceremony for the 10-meter air rifle men will now take place. The medals will be presented by Engineer Obrist, the president of the Italian Target Shooting Association, accompanied by Mr. Caputo and Mr. Mazut, members of the board of the Italian Target Shooting Association. The bronze medal goes to Seri Kulish from Ukraine with a total score of 701.5. The silver medal goes to Vitaly Bubnovich from Belarus with a total score of 701.7. And the gold medal goes to Niccolò Campriani from Italy with a total score of 702.7. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Italy. Ladies and gentlemen, we congratulate the winners of the 10-meter air rifle men event. Niccolò Campriani, Vitaly Bubnovich, Serhiy Kulish.